Wet your hands with water. Apply soap, rub your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub. And then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most merciful and most gracious. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hopefully, you all will be fine. First of all, I would like to say welcome in my online lecture of social studies subject and Saudi history for grade 2. This is week number 2 and lecture number 2. As you know, my name is Mrs. Sadaf Amreen. General instructions. Here are some general instructions, so listen carefully. First of all, dear students, mark your attendance. Secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser, and sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. And if you have any questions, please ask questions in WhatsApp group. Hope the instructions are clear to follow. Lesson number 4, living together. The same lesson will be continued today also. So we will do some exercises of this lesson by today. Okay, so get ready for that. Lesson number 4, living together. The contents are preview, exercise D, oral, page number 21, Saudi history. Question number 2. Three things we will do today. So, first of all, I will give you a quick preview of the lesson that we have studied previously. The lesson number 4, living together. And today we will do exercise D. That will be an oral exercise. And the page number is 21. Today we will also do our question number 2 of Saudi history that you have to note down on your notebook. Okay. Preview of lesson number 4, living together. We have studied some things, some rules that are very important to live a happy life while living together. So I will quickly revise all that. Okay. Lesson number 4, living together. We all want to live with someone because we want to talk to someone, we want to play with others, we want to live. We don't want to live alone, because if we live alone, we can't enjoy, we cannot talk to anyone. So we need people to live with them, to talk with them, to play with them. So that's why there are some rules. If we follow those rules, we can live a happy life while living together. So what are those rules? Let's see. The very first rule is sharing. Sharing is a very important rule. You feel you feel happiness when someone shares something to you. Similarly, the other feels happy when you share something to others. So you can see here are some examples of sharing. When you play, if someone is not playing with you and he or she is just watching, so feel his grief or feel his pain or her pain. So you should share your toys, everything to others, other kids. In this way, all you can play, not only you can also enjoy and play together. So you can see here, yeah, there is an example. Look at the very first picture. The boy is sitting because he is crying because her bat is broken. The other boy is offering his own bat, and look at the smile that on his face. In the second picture, you can see there are two children and they are sharing their food. And there is another example of sharing. There are two girls, they are also sharing their lunch. And in the last picture, you can see there are some children, they are playing with their toys and they are sharing their toys with each other. So sharing is a very good rule. When you share something, the other person will happy whose you share something. Okay, so sharing is a very important rule to live a happy life while living together. Taking turns, it also very important rule. You can see here different kinds of picture in which you can see that how you have to wait for your turn by playing different games. So look at the very first picture. There are two girls, they are jumping through the rings. So one is playing and the other girl is just waiting for her turn. In the second picture, you can see also the two boys are, one boy is taking swing, the other one is just waiting for his turn. And in the third picture, the girls are playing with the rope, one is playing, the others are waiting. And in the next picture, you can see there are two boys, one is riding on the cycle and the other one is waiting for his turn. Now the boy who is riding is going to give the cycle to the other boy who is waiting for his turn. And the next picture, you can see the children are playing a game that is round robin. So they will play when their turn will come. They will speak something and other is listening. Then the other child speak when his turn will come. And you can see the next picture, there are children who are coming through the tunnel and they are waiting for their turn and they are standing in a queue. They have made a line. So, and next picture, you can see the children are taking slides and they are also making a queue. They are standing in the line and they are waiting for their turn. And another picture, there are two boys who are playing chess and they are waiting, one is playing, the other one is waiting for his or her turn. In this way, when you will play, you will maintain the discipline also, and you can save from any injury or any mishap while playing together. Otherwise, if you push and pull, you can many accident can be happen. To avoid all these kinds of mishaps, you should follow the rule taking turns. Okay, so taking turn is a very important rule to live a happy life while living together. Okay, another rule is queuing. Queuing means standing in a line or making a line. You can see in the very first picture, you can see ATM queue. People are standing in the queue and they are waiting for their turn. When their turn will come, one by one, they will take the money and then go away. So in this way, there is no hurdle or there is no mishap, or you can say everything will go smoothly, and they can take their money or they can do their work easily. Now the next picture you can see, there is a teacher who is and there are some students who are standing in a line, means they have made a queue. So you also made a queue when you stand in the assembly, or when you go to the classroom after finishing the assembly, and at leaving time you have to make a queue or you have to make a line. So when you make a line, you will move in a line. You cannot you can go smoothly, you can save from different types of injuries, you can avoid all kinds of mishap like falling down or other kinds of mishaps. So making queue is a very important. In the third picture you can see people are waiting for their photos, and they are standing in the line, and there are some children also, they are also standing in the line to move forward. Next picture, the last picture is you can see here are some people who are standing in the line to buy some tickets. So everything will go smoothly if you will follow these rules. If you will not follow the queuing rule, you can maybe any accident can happen, and for that reason you may hurt or you may injure. So to avoid all those things, you should follow these rules while living together. Okay. Feelings. When we live together, different people meet us, different people play with us, different people say something to us. So as a result, we feel different feelings. Sometimes due to some reason we feel happy, sometimes we sad, angry, scared, silly, excited, surprised, shy and embarrassed. So there are different kinds of feelings that we can feel at different types of situations. So when we live together, we must have to face these types of feelings all throughout our lives. So these are very important, because when we happy, it means you are enjoying. And how you can enjoy? Only by living together, only by playing together. You cannot enjoy by playing alone. When you meet with your friends, you talk with your friends, or you play with your friends, you can enjoy. So when you enjoy, you feel happy. So there are different kinds of feelings: happy, sad, angry, scared. So these are the part of life. So we should take care of others while living together. In our previous lecture, we have also studied about the classroom rules. So what are those rules? I will quickly revise also. This was the exercise C, make up 3 rules for your classroom. Work page is 21. Page number is 21. Okay, so what are the classroom rules that we have done in the previous lecture? Let's see. Be quiet and listen to the teacher. That is very important to learn. Okay, to maintain the discipline in the class. So you should be quiet and listen to the teacher. This is the very first and most important rule, classroom rule. Okay. Second one, raise your hand and wait to be called on before speaking. If you want to speak, you have to raise your hand, and you should wait till the teacher allow you to speak. So raise your hand and wait to be called on before speaking is a second important rule of the classroom. The third rule that we have done, that is ask permission before leaving the room. Okay, understand, if you want to go outside, you have to ask permission to the teacher that may I want to go to washroom, or any other purpose you want to go outside. So you have to ask permission for that. So ask permission before leaving the room is the third rule of the classroom. Now Word page, page number 21, exercise D. That is an oral exercise. No need to write down the anything, but this is oral exercise. And if we but we are not facing to each other, means teachers and students are not in the school atmosphere, so I have just written here some consequences. The question is, what should happen if someone breaks a rule? Okay, there are different kinds of rule. As we are talking about the classroom rules, so regarding that, I have written some consequences to break a rule. So the very first consequence is a warning should be given and a fine. Number two is a fine. If we study regularly in the classroom, then I have to ask to you. You have to decide what are the punishments or what are the consequences should be to break a rule. Okay. So, but here we are taking distance education, so that's why I have written two consequences over here. So number one is a warning should be given, and number two is a fine. So this is oral exercise. Okay, ये आपने note down नहीं करना. You don't have to write these two consequences on your notebook. This is just an oral exercise, and it is almost about the discussion type. But we are not facing to each other, so that's why I have written over here, and I am telling you that I have decided these two rules. But if we were studying in the school on regular basis, so at that time I must say that you have to decide, and we will discuss all the consequences verbally, orally over there. But here I have written two. You should note down, but you should keep in mind these two consequences. That is, a warning should be given, and the two is fine. Okay, no need to note down these. Okay, just keep in mind. Okay, now the Saudi history. Next slide we will do a Saudi history. So get ready for your Saudi history subject. Saudi history. So you have to open your social studies copies or Saudi history copies for writing the question. And today we will do question number 2 of week number 2. Okay, Saudi history question number 2. What is said at the beginning of the meal? Answer is Bismillah. Bismillah. B-I-S-M-I-L-L-A-H. Bismillah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. When we have to start eating, we must say Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. ठीक है, खाना खाने से पहले कौन सी दुआ पढ़नी होती है? बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम. सो व्हाट इज सेड एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द मील? आंसर इज बिस्मिल्ला. व्हाट इज द आंसर? बिस्मिल्ला. यू हैव टू नोट डाउन दिस आंसर ऑन योर सोशल स्टडीज कॉपीज इफ यू डोंट हैव अ सेपरेट नोटबुक फॉर सऊदी हिस्ट्री. सो यू शुड नोट दिस आंसर ऑन सऊदी सोशल स्टडीज कॉपीज as you have already made a separate portion of the Saudi history for Saudi history in your social studies copies. Okay, so you should open your Saudi history portion and note down this question. Question number 2. What is said at the beginning of the meal? Hurry up, quickly note down. You have to note down. What question number 2? What is said at the beginning of the meal? Answer is Bismillah. Bismillah. B-I-S-M-I-L-L-A-H. Bismillah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. You can also write, when you are writing the answer of this question, you can also write Bismillahirrahmanirrahim as I have written on the slide. Okay, if you want to write, otherwise it's okay. So today we have studied Saudi history question number 2. What is said at the beginning of the meal? हमें क्या कहना चाहिए, खाना खाने से पहले क्या पढ़ना चाहिए? आंसर इज बिस्मिल्लाह। वी शुड रिसाइट बिस्मिल्लाह, ठीक है? बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। व्हाट इज़ द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम? इन द नेम ऑफ अल्लाह हु इज़ द मोस्ट मर्सीफुल एंड मोस्ट ग्रेशियस। इन उर्दू शुरू करती हूँ या करता हूँ अल्लाह के नाम से जो नहायत मेहरबान और रहम करने वाला है। ओके, सो होपफुली यू हैव नोटेड दिस। हेयर वी हैव डन क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, सऊदी हिस्ट्री वीक नंबर टू। व्हाट इज सेड एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द मील? आंसर इज बिस्मिल्लाह। ओके, एनी क्वेश्चन? If you have any question, you can ask me in the WhatsApp group. Okay? That's all about from my side. Thank you for listening and watching. Stay blessed always. Have a nice day. Allah Hafiz.
बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स। दिस इस्लामियात लेक्चर इज प्रेजेंटेड टू यू बाय पाकिस्तान इंटरनेशनल स्कूल रियाद फॉर द सब्जेक्ट इस्लामियात ग्रेड टू and week second and lecture also second and I am your Islamiyat teacher, Mrs. Nishat Ismat. Dear students, here is our contents of today's lecture. So the content of our today's lecture are, first of all, now you can see here aim that what we will be doing in our today's lecture. And after that, and then I will tell you your homework that you have to do something at home. Okay, now move next. Today's aim, dear student, today's aim is here. Unit 3, the profit review. Dear students, as you know, we have already done of this unit, the profits. Okay, we have done in the previous lecture, but today I will give you a review only this unit. Okay, and next we will do exercise 1, page 16, question C, D, E, short answer on copy. We have also already done in previous lecture. And question A, detailed answer on copy, this one also done. And worksheet we will do today's lecture, worksheet unit 3. Okay, today we will do worksheet unit 3. हम यूनिट 3 की वर्कशीट भी फिल करेंगे. ओके, नाउ वी नेक्स्ट. ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एक्सरसाइज 1, आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस. क्वेश्चन ए, डिटेल आंसर ऑन कॉपी. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, बट टुडे आई विल गिव यू ओनली रीकैप. Oh, now you can see here question A, who were prophets? Who were prophets? Now you can see the answer. Prophets were Allah's messengers. They were all very good men. Who were prophets? Prophets were Allah's messengers. They were all very good men. Okay, this one is question A, but only recap we have done in the previous lecture. Next, this question oral discussion. Question B, only oral discussion. How did Allah send his message to his people? How did Allah send his messages to his people? This question is only oral discussion. Okay, Allah sent us his message and guidance through his prophet. Allah sent us his messages and guidance through his prophets. Prophet received wahi or messages from Allah and delivered these to the people. They were all very good and God-fearing men. Okay, how did Allah send his messages to his people? Allah sent us his messages and guidance through his prophets. Okay, now next move. Here is exercise 1, answer these questions, short answer C, D, E. Dear student, listen to carefully. We have already done in the previous lecture. Only today I will give you a recap. Okay? Exercise 1, question C. Who was the first prophet of Allah? Who was the first prophet of Allah? Now you can see your answer. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was the first prophet of Allah. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was the first prophet of Allah. Next, question D. Question D, who was the last prophet of Allah? Who was the last prophet of Allah? Can you tell me, anyone tell me, who was the last prophet of Allah? Yes, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was the last prophet of Allah. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was the last prophet of Allah. Who was the last prophet of Allah? Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was the last prophet of Allah. Okay, next move. Question E. Question E. How many prophets were given holy books? How many prophets were given holy books? Answer is here. Four prophets were given holy books. Four prophets were given holy books. How many prophets were given holy books? Four prophets were given holy books. Dear students, already you have done in the previous lecture these prophets' name. Okay, these four prophets' name we have read this one. But now I tell you, which one four prophets? Hazrat Musa alayhi salam received Torah. Hazrat Musa alayhi salam received Torah. Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam received Zabur. Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam received which one? Yes, Zabur. And Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Injil. Yes, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Injil. And Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was given the last and final book, the Holy Quran. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was given the last and final book. Which one book? The Holy Quran. Yes, good. Good. Next. Okay, my dear students, here is activity discussion about Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam life. Okay, discussion about Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam life. My dear students, as you know, our dear Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was born in, where was born? Can you tell me? Where was born Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam? Yes, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was born in Makkah. Born in Arabia in 570 CE in Arabia. Okay, and Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam father was Hazrat Abdullah. What was the name of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam father? Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam father name was Hazrat Abdullah and his mother name was Bibi Amina. Okay, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam father name was Abdullah and his mother name was Bibi Amina. His father died even before he was born. His father died even before he was born, and he belonged to the tribe of Quraysh. Okay, who were the guardians of the Holy Kaaba? They were well respected people. Okay, my dear students, and about knowing Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the young Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam was a very well behaved. ओके हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम अपनी छोटी सी एज में ही जब मैं वो बच्चे थे तब भी वो उनका बिहेव स्टार्ट से ही शुरू से ही बहुत अच्छा था सबके साथ, छोटों के साथ भी, बड़ों के साथ भी, अमीर के साथ भी, गरीब के साथ भी, सबके साथ. ओके द यंग हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम वाज अ वेरी वेल बिहेव चाइल्ड. He never bothered or fought anyone. Okay, from the very beginning, he was a very soft-spoken and a quiet by nature. He was helpful and kind-hearted. Okay, and he did not waste his time by playing games with others, children of his age. Okay, my dear students. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was a very well behaved child. And you know, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was a very honest and truthful person. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was the very honest and truthful person. Even as a child, he never told a lies. जब वो बच्चे थे तब भी वो झूठ नहीं बोलते थे. ओके एज ही ग्रू अप हिज रेपुटेशन ऑफ कंप्लीट ऑनेस्टी स्प्रेड ऑल ओवर मक्का एंड पीपल स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग हिम एंड यू नो व्हाट पीपल कॉलिंग हिम सादिक एंड अमीन. People calling him Sadiq and Ameen, which mean truthful person. Sadiq and Ameen का क्या मतलब है? Sadiq and Ameen का मतलब है सच बोलने वाला और अमानतदार person. Okay, my dear students, and you know, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam choose business as his profession. Okay. उन्होंने अपने प्रोफेशन में बिजनेस को सिलेक्ट किया विच इन दोज डेज वाज कॉमन अमंग द अरब्स. ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम वेंट ऑन हिज द फर्स्ट बिजनेस ट्रिप टू कहां सरिया एंड विद हिज अंकल अबू तालिब. ओके And he often joined his relatives in other business trip abroad. Later, he took charge of Hazrat Khutija business. And you know, the Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was completely honest and fair in business dealing. Okay, the Prophet was completely honest and fair in business dealing. वो अपनी अपना जो बिजनेस करते थे उसमें बहुत अपनी अमानत में ख्यानत नहीं करते थे, बहुत सच्चाई के साथ बिजनेस करते थे. ओके ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम वाज जेंटल इन हिज मैनर सॉफ्ट स्पोकन काइंड हार्टेड. ही वाज गुड टू हिज फैमिली रिलेटिव्स एंड फ्रेंड्स एंड ही वाज हेल्पफुल टू हिज नेबर्स to his travelers, strangers, and you know, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved children. Okay, वो बच्चों से बहुत ज़्यादा प्यार करते थे हज़रत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम. Okay, okay, my dear students, I hope you will understand very well. Understand? Our dear Prophet loved children very much. He played with them. He patted them on the back and head, then finger through their hair and carried them in his arm. Okay? And also children love him too. और बच्चे भी उनसे बहुत प्यार करते थे. Okay, my dear students, and you know, you can see here. आपको पता है ये क्या है? Can you tell me? Yes, I hope all of you know about this. मुझे पता है आप सब इसके बारे में जानते हैं. This is the place where our dear Prophet Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born. ये वो जगह है जहाँ हमारे हजरत मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम पैदा हुए थे. ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट दिस. यस, आप जानते ना सब इसके बारे में. यस आई होप. ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट, नेक्स्ट. ओके नाउ यू कैन सी हियर हजरत आदम अलैहि सलाम. हजरत Adam alayhi salam, can you tell me the first human being on the earth? Which one? Yes, the first human being on the earth, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. The first human being on earth, which one? Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. Yes. And one day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called his angels and said to them that he was going to make a man. Okay, one day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called his angels and said to them that he was going to make a man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then made the first man with clay. किसके साथ बनाया था? विद क्ले. द फर्स्ट ह्यूमन बीइंग हज़रत आदम अलैहिस्सलाम अल्लाह मेड द विद क्ले. एंड यू नो व्हेन हज़रत आदम अलैहिस्सलाम आईज ओपन एंड हज़रत आदम अलैहिस्सलाम सीज जन्ना. नाउ व्हेन आदम अलैहिस्सलाम सीज जन्ना ही सीज द ब्यूटीफुल प्लेसेस, ब्यूटीफुल ट्रीज एंड ब्यूटीफुल फ्रूट्स. And see all of this beautiful around him. Okay, and Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, Adam alayhi salam, his soul, all of angels fell on sajda to him. और Allah Taala ने सब angels को हुक्म दिया था कि Adam alayhi salam को सजदा करें. और आपको पता है कि सब angels ने सजदा किया था, और किसने नहीं किया था? इब्लीस ने नहीं किया था. दे ऑल फेल इन द सजदा बट इब्लीस जस्ट स्टूड देयर. सिर्फ इब्लीस वहां पे खड़ा रहा था एज द एंजल्स मेड सजदा. ओके ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट, द फर्स्ट ह्यूमन बीइंग ऑन द अर्थ हजरत आदम अलैहिस्सलाम. यस गुड, नेक्स्ट. Okay, my dear students, today we will do worksheet of unit 3. Now you can see here worksheet 1, unit 3. This worksheet is only unit 3. Okay, worksheet unit 3, you will write here name and you will write here class and sections. Okay, this worksheet is made up of unit 3 only. Okay. First of all, you will write it here name, and after that you class and section, then you will complete it. Okay. First of all, question 1. First of all, question 1, circle the correct answer. Circle the correct answer you can do. Okay, my dear student, as you wish, you can do the circle, you can do the tick, anyone. Okay. Allah sent us his messages through his, let's see question 1, sorry, one number 1. Allah sent us his messages through his dash, which one? Angels, prophets. Allah sent us his messages through his angels, prophets. Who tell me? Allah sent us his messages through his prophets. Yes, through his prophets. Next one, the first human being on the earth was Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, Hazrat Daud alayhi salam. Which one? The first human being on the earth was, yes, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. The first human being on earth was Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. Next, the last prophet was Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, Hazrat Adam alaihi salam. The last prophet was Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. The last prophet was Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Next, all the prophets were very dash, rude, God-fearing. All the prophets were very God-fearing. All the prophets were very God-fearing. Next one, Allah will reward those who dash Him. Allah will reward those who dash Him. Allah will reward those who obey Him. Allah will reward those who obey Him. Okay, my dear student, you must learn it and you must complete it at home. आपने वर्कशीट बस उसको याद करना है कि टीचर ने क्या क्या काम दिया है, उसमें कैसे फिल करना है, और उसको घर में लाजमी इसकी प्रैक्टिस करनी है. ओके ओके माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड वेरी वेल ऑफ दिस यूनिट, यूनिट 3. नेक्स्ट वन आल्सो दिस पार्ट ऑफ दिस वर्कशीट्स, क्वेश्चन 2. ओके, ये भी वर्कशीट का पार्ट है, क्वेश्चन 2 है. Before you complete the question 1, now we'll do question 2. Write true or false. Okay. Prophets receive wahi from Allah. Who tell me? Prophet received wahi from Allah. Is it true? False. But yes, is it true? Prophet receive wahi from Allah. Very good. Next one. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Zabur. Is it true? Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Zabur. Who tell me? No. False. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Injil. Yes. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Injil. So, here is Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Zabur, so that's wrong. No, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam received the Injil. That means Zabur is wrong. That means this one is false. Okay. Next one, Allah sent more than 1,28,000 prophets. Allah sent more than 1,28,000 prophets. Is it true? No, false. This one also false. Because Allah sent more than 1,24,000 prophets. Not 1,28,000. Allah sent more than 1,24,000 prophet. That's mean, is it false? Not true. Good. Very good. Next one, Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was a prophet. Is it true? Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was a prophet. Obviously, yes, true. Hazrat Adam alayhi salam was a prophet. Yes, true. Next one, Muslims believe in all the prophets. Muslim believes in all the prophets. Is it true? Yes, is it true? Muslim believe in all the prophets. Because my dear students, as you know, all of you know, we are Muslims. Alhamdulillah, we are Muslim and we believe in all the prophets. Being a Muslim, we are believe in all the prophets. Okay, that means is it true? Okay, my dear students, I hope you will understand very well of this part, true and false. Okay, my dear students, I hope you will understand very well of this unit 3. Okay, मुझे उम्मीद है कि आपको unit 3 आप बहुत अच्छे तरीके से लर्न हो गई होगी. It's question answer, it's worksheets, short question, detailed question, all of you done and well prepared, well revised. Okay, good. Now my dear student, here is your homework. You can see here home assignment unit 3, and can tell me what you have to do at home. Only you will fill the worksheet at home. Okay, आपने वर्कशीट फिल करनी है और उसकी प्रैक्टिस करनी है. ओके 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 माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन, इफ यू हैव एनी क्यूरीज, इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट, यू कैन आस्क योर इस्लामियात टीचर. ओके, थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग टू मी. टेक केयर. अल्लाह हाफिज.
Assalamu alaikum and good evening everyone. How are you my dear students? Hope all of you are fit and fine. I welcome you in my computer science class. And I am your computer teacher, Miss Zermina. So today we are going to cover lecture 2 of week number 2. So get ready, take out your books. Take out your books quickly. Today we are going to revise the previous topics of chapter number 5. Now who is going to tell me the name of chapter? Very good, chapter 5. The name of chapter is Editing in Notepad. So get ready for it. And keep your pencils with you. Here are the contents. First of all, we are going to revise the previous topic. All of the topics that has been covered in chapter number 5. Then we are going to move to the book exercise. We are going to attempt book exercises. Then at the end, you will have a home task. So, we are going to start with the revision of the previous topic. We started our topic with the introduction of Notepad. Now, who is going to tell me what is Notepad? Very good. Everyone is right. They are telling the right answers. Notepad is a program in which you can edit text. Or you can write text in your Notepad application. So, editing in Notepad means you can cut, copy, paste, find and replace text in the edit menu. All of these options where you can find? Yes, you can find these options in the edit menu. All of these like undo, cut, copy, paste, find and replace options are in the edit menu in Notepad application. So on page number 2 also we covered undo. What's the meaning of undo? Undo means to cancel the changes. Cancel the previous changes that you have made in the document. Then we also studied about cut. Cut means to remove or to erase the text and if you want to paste it, then you can also paste the cut part in another area. Copy, you can copy the text and place it on another place in the document area. And then you can also paste with the help of edit menu. You can go over there and you can also use keyboard shortcuts. Then we've studied about find. If you want to search for any text or word in the Notepad document, you can find it with the help of edit menu. And the last one was replace. And if you want to change any word, you can replace it. For this, where you have to go? Very right, you have to go into the edit menu. So these are the topics we covered in chapter number 5, editing in Notepad. So moving on to the keyboard shortcuts. As you already know that the meaning of shortcut is the easier way to do anything. So there are so many shortcuts we studied in this chapter. Like if you want to copy your text, what you have to press? Very good. You have to press Control C. And what you have to press when you want to cut any text? Think about it. What is the shortcut, keyboard shortcut for cut? Very good. You have to press Control X. This is how you are going to cut the text in Notepad application. And when you want to paste text, what you are going to press? Excellent! You will press Control V. Control V, you are going to press Control V, and this is how you can paste your text. Undo. If you want to cancel the changes, then you will press what you are going to press? You are going to press Control Z. And if you want to find the text in Notepad document, you are going to press Control F. And for replacing any word, you are going to press Control H. These are the keyboard shortcuts we studied in this chapter. So, how many are these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Cut, copy, paste, undo, find, and replace. So, we studied 6 shortcuts, keyboard shortcuts. Very good. Now, moving on to the next slide, that is the edit or menu. Right now you can see on your screen that is an edit menu from where you can edit text if you are using mouse. If you are not using your keyboard, then you can also do these editing in your Notepad document. So this is an edit menu. Undo, cut, copy, paste, find and replace. These are all the, you can also see the shortcuts in front of the words. So this is how you are going to do editing in the Notepad document with the help of mouse. You will just select the word or text and then go into the edit menu. When you click on edit menu, you can see these different options. From here you can edit the text with the help of your mouse. Now it's time for your book work. Open your book, as today we are going to complete exercise A, B, and C. Open your book quickly. Page number 26. We will start with page number 26. So we will start with exercise A, and you have to help me in completing the words. Or exercise 4. Exercise A is that, yeah, you have to fill in the blanks with the correct word. The words are given in the word bank. You can see paste, cut, find, undo, copy, and replace. These are the words given in the word bank. And what you have to do, you have to read the statement and then find which word will fit in this blank. So we will start with number 1. Dash means to look for any text. You want to search for in your document. Yes, who is going to tell me the answer of this statement? It's a, what you have to do when you want to find any or search for any word or text in your document. Very good. You will. It means find. Find means to look for any text you want to search for in your document. Okay, now move on to number 2. Number 2. Dash means making a copy of text from a document and placing it in the clipboard. Yes, clipboard is the area where data can be stored for a short time period. So, making a copy of text. What will come in this blank? It means if you want to copy any text from a document and you want to place that word into another area in the document, which word do you think it will come in this blank? Which word? Very good. Copy means making a copy of text. It's simply by reading a statement you can know the answer. because making a copy means to copy the text. Now move on to number 3. Dash means cancelling the previous result. Dash means cancelling the previous results. So which word means that cancel the previous changes that you have made? Undo. Very good. Undo means cancelling the changes or cancel the previous results that you have made. Now hope all of you have done it. I'm going to give you few more seconds so you can complete it and try to nice in a very good writing properly and neatly. So let's move on to number 4. Number 4 is dash means moving a section of text from a document to the clipboard. Dash means think about it. You want to move a section or part of text from document to the clipboard. What you are going to do, you will press cut, right? For this function, you have to press cut. So, cut means moving a section of text from a document to the clipboard. Now, moving on to number 5. Number 5, dash means to change any text with the one you want in your document. We have already done this in our practical also. Yes, now, who is going to tell me the answer of this blank? If you want to replace or change the word, what are you going to do? You will click on the replace and here the word that is replace means to change any text in the document. And if you want to change the word, when a new word you want to add, then you can replace it also in the notepad document. Now, number 6. Dash means copying or moving text from the clipboard to the document area. Now think about it carefully. You have already copied some text and then you want to move it from the clipboard. What is clipboard? Clipboard is the area where data can be stored for a short time period and you want to place that text into the document area. So it is paste. Very good, everyone. Everyone, very good. So, paste means copying or moving text from clipboard to the document area. Now, look at the number 4. It means moving the text from document to the clipboard. When you want to move text from document, you have to select the text and then copy it or cut it. This is how you can transfer it to the clipboard area. But in the 6th one, you can see that they are saying you want to move the text from clipboard to the document. So, read the sentence carefully and then you can answer it correctly. So, that is paste. Now, exercise B and C are on page number 27. So, open page number 27 for move on to page number 27 for exercise B and C. We will start with exercise B that is on page number 27. In this exercise, you have to read the statement and tell whether the statement is right or wrong and you have to mark a tick or cross. So, we'll start with the first one. Undo erases the last change done to the document. So, what is undo? Is this statement right or wrong? Undo means cancels the changes that you have made. So it says undo erases the last change done to the document. That is right. Very good, everyone. Now move on to number 2. Number 2 is the file menu provides all the editing options. File menu provides all the editing options or there is another menu that provide editing options. No, file menu do not provide all the editing options, so this statement is wrong, as the edit menu provide all the editing options. So that statement is not correct, so you will put cross. Now moving on to number 3. The editing options can be used quickly through keyboard shortcuts. Yes, we can do all of the editing with the help of keyboard shortcuts in a very easier way. So, is this statement right or wrong? Excellent, that is right. We can do editing in a quicker or easier way by using keyboard shortcuts. So now moving on to exercise C. Get ready, exercise C. So that in exercise C, that is on page number 27. In this exercise, what you have to do, you have to write the keyboard shortcuts. So moving on with the first one, who is going to tell me the keyboard shortcut for cut? If you want to cut text, which keyboard shortcut you are going to use? Bravo! Yes, you will use Control X if you want to cut text in Notepad document. Now, moving on to number 2. Copy. If you want to copy text using keyboard, which shortcut you are going to use? Think about it. For copying text, which keyboard shortcut you are going to use? You are going to use Control C. That is very right. Control C. Now, moving on to number 3. Let's move on to number 3. 3 is paste. It is written paste. If you want to paste the text in another area, which keyboard shortcut you are going to use? Control V. You are going to use Control V. You are going to use Control V by using keyboard. This is the shortcut for paste button. And now, undo. Undo means to cancel the changes that have been done into the document. So, what's the keyboard shortcut for undo? Very good. That is Control Z. Control Z. And now, moving on to number 5. That is find. If you want to search any specific word in the document, which keyboard shortcut you are going to press if you want to find the text? Very good, everyone. You will press F. Now moving on to number 6, replace. If you want to change the text or any word in the document, which keyboard shortcut you are going to use? Very good. You will press Control H. So these are the keyboard shortcuts for cut, copy, paste, undo, find, and replace. So try to memorize them, try to practice a lot so you will be able to memorize them. Now it's time for your home task. What is your home task? Your home task is that you have to practice all of the keyboard shortcut buttons and practice it a lot. Then you have to complete the book exercises. Your homework is same that if you have done it right now, then you can learn the exercises. You can learn the meaning of different words that we have done in exercise A. Now it's time for preview. In our next lecture, we are going to start chapter 7, that is document in the word pad. In chapter 5, we studied document in notepad, editing in notepad. Now, in chapter 7, we are going to cover a new topic that is about WordPad, and that is on page number 35. So, moving on to that was it. That was our today's lecture. Hope you understood and completed your exercises. And take care of yourselves. Thank you for listening, and also take care of the ones around you. Inshallah, we will meet next week. Till then, Allah Hafiz. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. हाँ जी बच्चों, मैं आपकी कुरान टीचर मिसेज मकसूदा हूँ। आप सब कैसे हैं? अल्लाह ताला से उम्मीद करती हूँ कि आप लोग सब खैरियत से होंगे और अल्लाह ताला से दुआ करती हूँ कि अल्लाह ताला आपको अपने हिफ्ज़ो अमान में रखे और आपको सेहत वाली, सलामती वाली लंबी जिंदगी अता फरमाए और अल्लाह ताला आपको हर किस्म की रूहानी जिस्मानी बीमारियों और वबाओं से बचा करके अल्लाह ताला आपकी हिफाजत फरमाए और अल्लाह ताला आपके सीनों और जहनों को खोले, रोशन और मुनव्वर करे और अल्लाह ताला आपको हर इम्तहान में कामयाबियां अता फरमाए। और बेटा, ये ताकीद करती हूँ कि जिस तरह से आपको हरूफ का तलफ्फुज़ सिखाया जा रहा है, जिस तरह हरूफ आपको सिखाए जा रहे हैं, आप उसी तरह इसकी प्रैक्टिस करके उसी तरह याद करें ताकि आपके जहनों में ये सही तलफ्फुज जो है, सही अदायगी जो है, वो बैठ जाए। क्योंकि बेटा अभी आपके सीखने की एज है, इसमें आप जिस तरह सीखेंगे फिर उसी तरह आपके जहन में ये बैठ जाएगा। और बेटा, जो सूरतें आपको याद करवाई जा रही हैं, वो सूरतें अच्छे तरीके से याद करके उनको अपनी नमाज के अंदर पढ़ें ताकि वो हमेशा आपको याद रहें, फिर वो भूलें ना। और बेटा, दुआएं जो आपको सिखाई जा रही हैं, दुआएं सिखाने का मतलब ये है कि क्योंकि नबी करीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम सुबह से लेके शाम तक, फिर शाम से लेके सुबह तक के का सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम का ये मामूल था कि आप सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम हर मौके पर दुआ पढ़ा करते थे, तो आपको भी इसलिए सिखाई जा रही है ताकि आप भी ये सारी दुआएं याद करके अपने दिन और रात को नबी करीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम के तरीके के मुताबिक जो है अपना दिन और रात गुजारें। ठीक है, तो इन अपनी दुआओं को अच्छे तरीके से याद करें और फिर जिस जिस वक्त की आपको दुआ याद करवाई जा रही है, आप उस वक्त में उस दुआ को पढ़ें और अपनी जिंदगी में उनको अप्लाई करके अच्छे तरीके से अपना दिन और रात गुजारने की कोशिश करें। चलें, ठीक है, अब हम चलते हैं अपने सबक की तरफ। हाँ जी मेरे प्यारे प्यारे बच्चों, आज हम इंशाअल्लाहुल अजीज पढ़ेंगे नाजरा कुरानी कायदा का पेज नंबर 19 एंड 20। पेज नंबर 19 और 20 हम पढ़ेंगे इंशाअल्लाहुल अजीज। और हिफ्स में आज जो हमने याद करना है, जबानी जो हमने याद करना है, वो है घर से निकलने की दुआ। ठीक है बेटा, जबानी याद करेंगे घर से निकलने की दुआ और नाजरा देखकर हम पढ़ेंगे कुरानी कायदा का पेज नंबर 19 एंड 20। ठीक है बेटा, चलें आप लोग निकाल लें पेज नंबर 19 एंड 20। हाँ जी बच्चों, ये देखें आपके सामने दो पेज का पेज खुल चुका है, पेज नंबर 19। ठीक है, पेज नंबर 19 है ये। पेज नंबर 19 को हम इंशाल्लाह अब पढ़ेंगे। ठीक है, और आपको पता है कि पेज नंबर 19 जो है, इसके ऊपर दो पेश हैं। ठीक है, दो पेश कैसे होती हैं? एक सीधी पेश होती है और एक उल्टी पेश होती है। ठीक है, ये है पेज नंबर 19। देखें यहाँ भी लिखा हुआ है, ठीक है, यहाँ नीचे पेज पर भी लिखा हुआ, यहाँ भी लिखा हुआ है और यहाँ भी। पेज नंबर 19 आप लोग खोलें और दो पेश की आप बेटा अच्छी तरह से पहचान कर लें कि दो पेश इस तरह की होती हैं, छोटी सी वाव होती है, एक सीधी होती है और एक उल्टी होती है। ठीक है, इसको दो पेश बोलते हैं। ठीक है, अब दो जबर दो जेर के बाद अब हम इंशाल्लाह पढ़ेंगे क्या? दो पेश। ठीक है, तो इसको इस तरह पढ़ना है, हमजा दो पेश उन, बा दो पेश बुन, ता दो पेश तुन, सा दो पेश सुन। सुन, सा की आपको पता है कहां से आवाज निकलेगी? हाँ जी, जबान की नोक और फिर सामने वाले दो दांतों के सिरे, वो आपस में मिलेंगे तो क्या अदा होगा? सा सा। ठीक है, सा दो पे सुन, जीम दो पेश जुन, सा दो पे सुन, जीम दो पेश जुन, हा दो पेश हुन, खा दो पेश खुन, दाल दो पेश दुन, رال دو پہ زن، را دو پہ رون، زا دو پہ زن زا. ٹھیک ہے، یہ ہے زال زال. سا اور زال ایک ہی جگہ سے ادا ہوں گے. زال دو پہ زن، ٹھیک ہے، را دو پہ رون، زا دو پہ زن، سین دو پہ سن، شین دو پہ شن، سواد سواد دو پہ سن، واد دو پہ زن، تا دو پہ تن، وا دو پہ زن، عین دو پہ عن. عین، عین کو آپ نے گلے کے درمیان سے نکالنا ہے، ٹھیک ہے. عین دو پہ عن، غین دو پہ غن، غین غین دو پہ غن، فا دو پہ فن، قاف دو پہ قن، قاف قاف دو پہ قن، کاف دو پہ کن، کاف قاف اور کاف. ٹھیک ہے، یہ موٹا قاف ہے، پر کر کے پڑھیں گے اور زبان کی جڑ سے ادا ہوگا. قاف قاف دو پیش کن، کاف دو پیش کن، لام دو پیش لن، میم دو پیش من، نون دو پیش نون. نون، ٹھیک ہے، نون دو پیش نون، واو دو پیش ون، واو واو دو پیش ون. ہا، ہا کو آپ نے گلے کے آخری حصے سے نکالنا ہے. ہا، ہا دو پیش ہن. ٹھیک ہے، یہ تھی ہا. ہا کو گلے کے درمیان سے نکالنا ہے. ہا دو پیش ہن اور ہا دو پیش ہن. ہا اور ہا میں فرق کریں گے. ٹھیک ہے بیٹا، سمجھ آ رہی ہے آپ کو؟ ہا اور ہا، اس کی آپ نے پریکٹس کرنی ہے اچھے طریقے سے. ہا یہ، ٹھیک ہے، اور ہا ہا ہا. ٹھیک ہے، یہ ہا دو پیش ہن اور ہا دو پیش ہن، اور یہ بھی ہا دو پیش ہن. ٹھیک ہے، ہا دو پیش ہن، ہا دو پیش ہن، دونوں ہا ہیں. دونوں سینے کے پاس سے، جو گلا جہاں سے سٹارٹ ہوتا ہے، ہماری نیک جہاں سے سٹارٹ ہوتی ہے، گلا جہاں سے سٹارٹ ہوتا ہے، وہی گلے کے آخری والے حصے سے جو ہے یہ دونوں ہا نکلیں گی. ٹھیک ہے، ہا دو پیش ہن، ہا دو پیش ہن. ٹھیک ہے، حمزہ دو پیش اون، حمزہ دو پیش اون. ٹھیک ہے، ہا دو پیش ہن، ہا دو پیش ہن، حمزہ دو پیش اون. تینوں حرفوں کا مخرج نکلنے کی جگہ ایک ہی ہے. یا دو پیش یون، ٹھیک ہے، حمزہ دو پیش اون، یا دو پیش یون. اس کو اسی طرح سے یاد کرنا ہے، ٹھیک ہے، مخارج کے ساتھ. اب ہم انشاءاللہ کرتے ہیں اس کی آگے مشق، پھر اور زیادہ آپ کو پتا چل جائے گا کہ ان دو پیش کو کس طرح سے پڑھنا ہے. جب ہم مشق میں پڑھیں گے، دوسرے حروف اس کے ساتھ مل کر آئیں گے. ٹھیک ہے، تو چلیں اب ہم اس کی مشق شروع کرتے ہیں. ہاں جی بیٹا، یہ ہے اس کی مشق کا پیج، کھل چکا ہے. دو پیش کی اب ہم کریں گے مشق. یہ ہے مشق کا پیج، جیسے میں نے آپ کو بتایا ہے، اور یہ ہے پیج نمبر 20. جیسے میں نے آپ کو بتایا ہے کہ جب یہ دونوں اور حرفوں کے ساتھ مل کر آئے گا، پھر ہم جب دو پیش پڑھیں گے تو پھر پتا چلے گا کہ ہم نے اس کو کس طرح سے پڑھنا ہے. اور آپ دیکھ رہے ہیں کہ پیش ہمیں آخر پہ آئی ہے. دو جو پیش ہیں، دو زیر ہیں، دو زبر ہیں، یہ کبھی بھی حرف کے نہ تو شروع میں آتی ہیں، نہ ہی درمیان میں کسی لفظ کے آتی ہیں، ہمیشہ یہ آخر پر آتی ہیں. دونوں زبر بھی، دونوں زیر بھی، اور دونوں پیش بھی. ٹھیک ہے، یہ ہمیشہ تنوین جو ہے وہ لفظ کے آخر میں آتی ہے. ٹھیک ہے، سمجھ آ گئی بیٹا؟ چلیں اب ہم اس کو پڑھنا شروع کرتے ہیں. با زبر با، قاف زبر قو، دونوں حرفوں کو ملائیں گے تو بنے گا باقا. را زبر را، پھر ہم نے تینوں کو حرفوں کو ملانا ہے تو بنے گا باقارا. پھر تا دو پیش تن، باقارا تن. ٹھیک ہے بیٹا، باقارا تن. حمزہ زبر آ، ہا زبر ہا، آہا دال دو پیش دن. کیا بنا بیٹا؟ آہا دن. Yes. سین پیش سو، را پیش رو، سورو را دو پیش رن، سورو رن،
قاف زیر قی طا زبر طا قی طا عین دو پیش عن قی طا عن حا پیشو میم پیش مو حو مو حا. جیسے میں نے بتایا نا آپ کو جب ہم سبق پڑھ رہے تھے کہ ہا ہا گلے کے درمیان سے ہا پیش ہو میم پیش مو ہو مو را دو پیش رون ہو مو رون خوا پیش خو شین پیش شو خوشو با دو پیش بن کیا بنا خوشو بن. یس عین زبر آ میم زبر ما آما لام دو پیش لن آمالن غین زبر غا با زبر با غابا را زبر را غابارا تا دو پشتن غاباراتن کاف پیش کو تا پشتو کوتو با دو پش بن کوتو بن زو پیش زو لام زبر لا کیا بنا بیٹا آپ لوگ بولیں زولا لام دو پش لن کیا بنے گا زولا لن زا زبر زا با زبر با زبا دال دو پیش دن تینوں حرفوں کو ملائیں گے کیا بنے گا زبا دن. یس زبا دن قاف زبر قا دال زبر دا قادا میم دو پیش من قادا من خوا پیش خو لام پیش لو خولو قاف دو پیش قن خولو قن خولو قن حا زبر حا سین زبر سا حاسا نون زبر نا حسانا تا دو پشتن حساناتن حساناتن قاف زبر قا تا زبر تا قاتا را زبر را قاتارا تا دو پشتن قاتاراتن قاتاراتن ضا زبر ضا میم زبر ما ضاما همزه دو پیش اون ضاما اون ضاما اون نون زبر نا صاد زبر صا ناصا با دو پیش بون ناصابون ناصابون کاف زبر کا لام زیر لی کالی میم زبر ما کالیما تا دو پشتن کالیماتن کالیماتن میم زبر ما لام زبر لا مالا کاف دو پش کن مالا کن میم زبر ما را زبر را کیا بنا بیٹا آپ لوگ بولے مارا ضا دو پش زن کیا بنا مارا زن. ٹھیک ہے بیٹا آپ لوگوں نے سب نے میرے ساتھ ساتھ پڑھنا ہے ٹھیک ہے. با زبر با شین زبر شا کیا بنا باشا را دو پیش رون تینوں حرفوں کو ملائیں گے کیا بنے گا باشا رون باشا رون قاف زبر قو سین زبر سا قاسا میم دو پیش من کیا بنا بیٹا آپ لوگ بولیں قاسا من را زبر را جیم پیش جو راجو لام دو پیش لون راجو لون راجو لون را زبر را جیم پیش جو راجو لام دو پیش لون راجو لون حا زبر حا را زبر را حارا جیم دو پیش جون کیا بنا بیٹا آپ لوگ بولے حارا جون. یس حارا جون دال زیر دی یا زبر یا دی یا تا دو پشتن کیا بنا بیٹا بولیں آپ لوگ صاحب دیا تن. یس حمزہ زبر آ شین زیر شی آشی را دو پیش رون کیا بنا بیٹا آ پھر شی رون آشی رون. ٹھیک ہے حمزہ پیش او زال پیش دو کیا بنا اوزو دونوں پر پیش ہے اوزو نون دو پیش نون اوزو نون لام زبر لا عین زیر عی لا عی با دو پیش بن لا عی بن لاعب را پیش رو سین پیش سو روسو لام دو پیش لون رسولن 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 کسی نے نہیں کہنا ٹھیک ہے سین کو چھوٹا پڑھنا ہے روسو رسولن ٹھیک ہے جیم پیش جو دال زبر دا جو دا دال دو پیش دن کیا بنا بیٹا جودا دن جودا دن یس ٹھیک ہے اب میں بیٹا آپ کو اس کے بارے میں یہ بتاؤں گی کہ ہم نے اگر ان میں سے جیسے میں نے آپ کو پہلے یہ بتایا کہ تنوین جو ہے چاہے وہ زبر کی ہے زیر کی ہے پیش کی ہے وہ ہمیشہ لفظ کے اینڈ پر آتی ہے تو اب میں یہ آپ کو بتاؤں گی کہ اگر ہم اینڈ پر وقف کرنا چاہتے ہیں رکنا چاہتے ہیں تو پھر جو ہے اس تنوین کا کیا بنے گا ٹھیک ہے تو یہ کیسے پڑھی جائے گی ٹھیک ہے اب جیسے ہم قرآن مجید میں پڑھ رہے ہیں یا یہاں قاعدے پر بھی پڑھ رہے ہیں تو ہم نے رکنا ہے ٹھیک ہے تو ہم باقاراتن کی جگہ پہ ہم پڑھیں گے باقارہ ٹھیک ہے اس کے اگر اس طرح کی تا ہو تو اس کے دونوں نقطے بھی تا بھی ختم ہو جائیں گے وہ ہا میں چلی جائے گی اور اس کے دونوں پیش بھی ختم ہو جائیں گے ٹھیک ہے دو زیر کی تنوین اور دو پیش کی تنوین جو ہے یہ وقف کی صورت میں ختم ہو جاتی ہے ٹھیک ہے بیٹا باقاراتن وقف کی صورت میں آئے گا باقارہ احدن وقف کی صورت میں احد جیسے ہم کہتے ہیں قل ہو واللہ احد ٹھیک ہے تو یہ احد سرورن سے سرور سرورن سے سرور قطعن سے قطع قطع حمرن سے حمر خشبن سے خشب ٹھیک ہے عملن سے عمل غبارتن سے غبارہ کتبن سے کتب ذلالن سے ذلل زبدن سے زبد قدامن سے قدم خلقن سے خلق حسنتن سے حسنہ جیسے ہم نے اوپر پڑھا نا باقارہ اسی طرح حسنہ قطارتن سے قطارہ ذمعن سے ذمح نصبن سے نصب کلمتن سے کلمہ ملکن سے ملک مرضن سے مرض بشرن سے بشر قسمن سے قسم رجلن سے رجل حرجن سے حرج دیاتن سے دیہ عشیرن سے عشیر اذنن سے اذن لعیبن سے لعیب رسولن سے رسول جدادن سے جداد ٹھیک ہے یہ اس طرح سے آپ نے اگر وقف کرنا ہے تو ایسے پڑھنا ہے اور بغیر وقف کے جیسے میں نے آپ کو پڑھا ہے باقاراتن احدن سرورن قطاعن ٹھیک ہے یہ ہم سمپل روٹین میں اس طرح پڑھیں گے لیکن اگر وقف کرنا ہے وقف ہو جاتا ہے کسی جگہ پہ تو پھر پڑھنا ہے باقارہ احد کتب زلل نصب رسل ٹھیک ہے سمجھ آ گئی بیٹا اچھے طریقے سے آپ نے اس کو اسی طرح سے دونوں طرح سے پڑھنا ہے دونوں پیش کے ساتھ بھی آپ نے پڑھنا ہے تنوین کے ساتھ بھی اور وقف کے ساتھ بھی آپ نے کم از کم اس کو 5 ٹائم یاد کرنا ہے ٹھیک ہے بیٹا ہاں جی بچو یہ ہے گھر سے نکلنے کی دعا اب ہم پڑھیں گے گھر سے نکلنے کی دعا اور اس گھر سے نکلنے کی دعا کا کیا فائدہ ہے یہ فائدہ ہے کہ جب ہم گھر سے نکلتے وقت یہ دعا پڑھیں گے کون سی دعا بسم اللہ توکلت علی اللہ لا حول ولا قوة الا باللہ جب ہم یہ دعا پڑھ کے بسم اللہ پڑھ کے گھر سے نکلیں گے تو کیا ہوگا بسم اللہ یعنی میں اللہ کے نام کا ذکر کرتے ہوئے اور اسی اللہ کی طلب کرتے ہوئے اور اپنے اللہ پر توکل کرتے ہوئے گھر سے نکل رہا ہوں اور جو اللہ پر توکل کرے अल्लाह ताला उसके सारे काम ठीक कर देता है, उसके सारे काम संवार देता है, फिर उसको किसी किस्म का कोई नुकसान नहीं होता। फिर जो को जब कहता है इंसान ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह, तो फिर क्या होता है, जब ये कहते हैं तो फिर उसे अल्लाह ताला हर किस्म के शैतान के शर से अल्लाह ताला उसको महफूज रखता है। यानी जब वो ये दुआ पढ़ के घर से बाहर जाता है तो फिर इसको किसी किस्म का कोई नुकसान नहीं होता, ठीक है, वो खैरो आफियत से फिर वापिस आ जाता है। ठीक है, तो चलें इसको पढ़ना शुरू करते हैं। हमने पढ़ना है इसको बिस्मिल्लाही, अल्लाह को हमने बारीक पढ़ना है, ठीक है, बिस्मिल्लाही 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 तवक्कल तु बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाही बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाही बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाही ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह। बिल्ला ही है ना, तो रुकने के लिए बिल्लाह जब वक्फ करते हैं, तो मैंने आपको बताया ना जब हम कायदा भी पढ़े थे तो उसमें भी मैंने आपको बताया कि जब हम वक्फ करते हैं तो आखिर की हरकत जो है वो फिर खत्म हो जाती है। जैसे बिल्ला ही है तो हम पढ़े हैं बिल्लाह, और यहाँ पर अल्लाह ही है ना, तो अगर हमने वक्फ करना है तो हम पढ़ेंगे अल्लाह। जैसे ये देखे मैं आपको पढ़ के बताती हूँ, बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अल्लाह, जब मैंने कहा अल्लाह, ठीक है, अल्लाह के नाम के साथ, ठीक है, यानी मैं शुरू करती हूँ, शुरू करता हूँ अल्लाह के नाम के साथ, ठीक है, और फिर क्या है, तवक्कल तू अल्लाह, और मैं भरोसा करता हूँ, मैं भरोसा करती हूँ अल्लाह पर, मैं इस घर से अल्लाह के नाम के साथ निकल रहा हूँ या निकल रही हूँ, मैंने अल्लाह पर भरोसा किया, ठीक है। आगे ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह, गुनाह से बचने की हिम्मत है मुझ में, यानी मुझ में गुनाह से बचने की ना तो हिम्मत है और ना ही नेकी करने की ताकत है, इल्ला बिल्लाह, मगर अल्लाह ताला की तौफीक से, मेरा अल्लाह मुझे तौफीक देगा तो मैं नेकी भी करूंगा और गुनाह से भी बचूंगा, ठीक है, इसका ये मतलब है। यानी मैं गुनाह से बचने की भी ताकत नहीं रखता, मुझे शैतान बहका देगा, मैं गुनाह कर लूंगा और नेकी करने की भी मुझ में ताकत नहीं, जब तक कि मेरा अल्लाह मुझे तौफीक ना दे मैं नेकी नहीं कर सकता। तो ये बहुत जरूरी है ये पढ़ना हर वक्त, घर से निकलते वक्त भी और वैसे भी, ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्ला, ये एक बहुत बड़ा खजाना है, इसको कहा जाता है ये जन्नत के खजानों में से एक खजाना है, ठीक है, बहुत बड़ा अल्लाह की तरफ से ये तोहफा है, ठीक है। चलें फिर पढ़ते हैं, पढ़ो बेटा, बच्चों आप सब मेरे साथ पढ़ें, बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाही बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाह बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कल तु अलल्लाही ला हौला वला कुव्वता ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कलतु अलल्लाही बिस्मिल्लाही तवक्कलतु अलल्लाही ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह। कितने बच्चों को याद हो गई है, जरा हाथ खड़ा करके मुझे बताएं, सारे बच्चे, शाबाश, वेरी गुड। और कितने बच्चे घर से निकलते वक्त इसको पढ़ के निकलते हैं, सब पढ़ते हैं, वेरी गुड, शाबाश, आप लोग तो बहुत ही अच्छे अच्छे बच्चे हो, आप लोग सब बहुत अच्छे बच्चे हो, ठीक है। घर से निकलते वक्त आपने इस दुआ को पढ़ना है, ठीक ठीक है, बिस्मिल्लाह तवक्कलतु अलल्लाह ला हौला वला कुव्वता इल्ला बिल्लाह। ठीक है बेटा, शाबाश, आपने इसको घर से निकलते वक्त जरूर पढ़ना है, ठीक है। और याद रखने ये बात के टीचर ने हमें बार बार ये कहा कि घर से निकलते वक्त पढ़ना है और अच्छे ऊंची आवाज से पढ़ना है। हो सकता है, मुमकिन है मामा भूल जाएं, पापा भूल जाएं, दूसरे बहन भाई भूल जाएं पढ़ना, आप ऊंची आवाज से पढ़ें ताकि सबको पता चल जाए कि घर से निकलते वक्त दुआ पढ़नी है, ठीक है ना। इस तरह कितने बच्चे करेंगे, सब इस तरह करेंगे, शाबाश, वेरी गुड। हाँ जी माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अब ये है आपका होमवर्क। आपने पेज नंबर कुरानी कायदा का 19 और 20 आपने देख कर पढ़ना है, और जबानी आपने क्या याद करना है, घर से निकलने की दुआ, ठीक है। ये आपने अच्छे तरीके से याद कर लेना है और फिर इसको पढ़ते रहना है, ठीक है बेटा। हाँ जी मेरे प्यारे प्यारे बच्चों, आप लोगों ने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से पढ़ा और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से सुना, और आप लोग साथ साथ पढ़ते रहे और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से पढ़ने के लिए थैंक यू वेरी मच, जज़ाकुमुल्लाह खैर। हाँ जी बच्चों, नेक्स्ट वीक तक के लिए इजाजत चाहती हूँ। अल्लाह हाफिज, फी अमानिल्लाह, अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू।